good evening and welcome to Straight to the Point. I've been asked many times how I managed to not only capture my hardware footage, but on how do I get it to look so clear? So much so that yes, I have been accused once or twice of actually using emulation. For all my Mega Drive variants, I use the same type of signal, RGB. This is the clearest native option you can get. I get my cables from this website because the quality is superb and it's not worth cheaping out on alternatives from eBay. I know this because of personal experience. I also use a reliable third-party power supply from this website for not only cleaner power, but it's a lot more organized when using a tower of power compared to using these three bricks. So I connect my Mega Drive to the mains and plug in the RGB cable. But where does the other end go? I'm glad you asked. Here is the G-SCART SW, an automatic switcher with 8 inputs with 0 image degradation, meaning I can hook up several consoles at once. But the best feature of this appliance is the two outputs. Output 2 uses another RGB cable that goes straight to my Sony BVM. And that's all there is to this side. The outcome looks out of this world. It really needs to be seen in person. Very few tweaks need to be made here, and I can enjoy lag-free gaming via this beauty. But this doesn't solve the question on how I capture my videos. Well, that's what output 1 is for. Via RGB, it goes to this scaler called the OSSC, which can line double, triple, quadruple, and even quintuple the picture it receives. 5x mode does mean it cuts a bit off the top and bottom pixels, so being a picky guy, I always use 4x mode, which goes great with my red border. There's a lot of settings you have to mess with, but with patience, you can tune in the crispest pixels. From here, the OSSC spits out a digital signal via HDMI, which goes into an automatic HDMI switcher due to other HDMI devices, which then goes into an HDMI splitter, which then showcases to either my TV, monitor, and of course, my capture card. I use the Magewell Pro 4K Plus LT, which has high enough bandwidth for full xRGB colors at 1080p 60fps. That's a full 444 resolution. Using OBS, I set the resolution to be an exact copy of the input, xRGB mode, full color range, and Bob's your uncle, I couldn't ask for a cleaner looking footage from real hardware. Then, because I can, I just double check the colors are accurate and make those changes to my OSSC. I do also have the Retrotink 5X, and this is always ready at a moment's notice. This fits into the equation by my BVM's pass-through ports, which means I can split the signal into the scaler whether the BVM is on or not. And from there, it gets upscaled automatically with minimal work from me. And you've guessed it, it goes out via HDMI into the switcher, and the rest speaks for itself. A few days ago on my secondary channel, I asked if you can tell which was hardware and which is emulation, and the results were very interesting, but which is which? Congratulations if you managed to get it right. But what if I gave you another two examples, but this time, instead of using Kager, I'll use a more accurate emulator, Blastem. Now, can you tell the difference? I'm interested to know what your thoughts are in the comments. And that's Straight to the Point.